What is up, everybody? Welcome back to Eclectic Beard, and one more for good measure. Since back in the day, I did three reactions a day, all UK hip hop and grime artists. This one is Devlin Community Outcast. It's another one that was recommended that I don't remember ever actually reacting to. So yeah, let's go ahead and get into it.
Devlin. Community Outcast, and this one's for all the characters that have been forgotten at the present time.
I love the imagery in this, just straight up, because it's folks that are down on, it's folks that are, they're not in well-to-do neighborhoods.
Time. Represented a jobless that I've been made redundant, that I got four kids and don't know how to fund them. Ever since the wife and the husband both lost their jobs at the office in London, now they feel financially trapped at a lock with the rats in a dingy old dungeon. Take this young father or two, signing on and another.
Dude, his flow on this is just incredible. Somebody represents for the jobless, those that lost their jobs and lost their jobs in London, but now, you know, they feel trapped, and that's oftentimes what happens. You can have a good job, you take and lose it, and then it's hard to take and get back on your feet, and you take and fall into a cycle of just, it's struggle.
Government says that his family are sponges. He's like, damn man, we ain't got a penny of a pan, let alone money for milk and nappies and trainers and jumpers. He got taken off site because it's cheaper to pay Europeans to labor in numbers. How's he gonna take care of his youngers? I represent for the people, let down by a nation.
A lot of times, that's when that a lot of folks, if they don't turn to government, they turn to crime, because you got to have a way to feed your family, and a lot of times they take a look to crime to take to get the money needed to do stuff like that. So.
And left in the streets where it's evil. Little kids surrounded by knives and heroin needles. I represent the people.
For the people that society forgot, left them where it's evil, surrounded by knives and heroin needles. Holy crap. Those that are down in the gutter, the ones that are basically society's outcasts.
Dress evil. Little kids surrounded by knives and heroin needles. I represent to the people. Let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Community outcasts, cold, tired and feeble. I represent for the homeless. Let down by a nation. More interested in war and invasion when children are sleeping at railway stations.
Ooh. Ooh. Mmm. Here, they're more concerned with the nation building and taking and making sure other people have democracy than taking and using what they've gained with the democracy here to take care of the people that they've got. Especially veterans and stuff like that. That's definitely a...
Stations, no home or money. They wish they could phone their mummy to put a hot meal in their tummy. So at night when the temperature drops, I'm asking you, remember what you've got. These kids go home to the cardboard box. They're the sole survivors, warming their hands with a flickering flame of the lighters. All their life they've been frightened, walk the streets with their heads down, knowing deep down inside that they've really been let down by a country that's crippled, and I thought mankind was supposed to be civil.
And the thing about it is too that there's a lot of people that wind up homeless after taking losing jobs and stuff like that. So the family winds up being homeless. And I've always told folks it's easier to find a job if you already have a job than it is to take and find a job when you don't have one. Because if you don't have one, they wonder why you're not employed and figure there must be something wrong with you. That's just the mindset of employers. And if they can come up in that way, like, that's just... Bro, this is top notch.
I represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Little kids surrounded by knives and heroin needles. I represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Community outcasts, cold, tired and feeble. I represent single mums, all alone on their own, trying to put food in a mouth for the two sons and the father's gone. There's no cash flow, lack of income, but that's just the way it is. She counts 15 needles, pushing her pram on the way to the lift. This is where Brown said it's safe to live and raise kids. She finds a way out of the block, with two kids and a pram and a rip and a stain on the top. She goes to sign on just to maintain the little she's got. For her kids' sake, they'll never see a decent life, but they can dream when they sleep tonight. They've been hung out and left to dry. The kids are in bed, mum's left to cry. I represent...
Bro, this whole track right here is just giving me goosebumps. Like, it's because it's a I don't care what anyone says. Your socioeconomic situation, either that you're born into or through no fault of your own that you're cast into. The world's moved away from the caste system for the most part, other than like India, which I'm not sure how that works there anymore. Cause I don't know. I think they've changed that, but still, it serfdom, you know, caste systems and serfdom, you know, fiefdoms and stuff like that. But if you take a look at modern day life and the way things are done, like the age old thing is, oh, pull yourself up by your bootstraps. When you try to pull yourself up so much that you break your bootstraps and you try to take and go out and do what's necessary to survive. And it's just, it doesn't matter. Like, people take and resort to extreme measures. People act like there aren't places where jobs just don't exist. And if you don't have money, you can't move to somewhere else that does have jobs. It just doesn't work that way. I don't care what anybody says. It does not work that way. Then you're stuck in a holding pattern. Like, places like that exist. And the situations it causes and stuff like that. Here in America, we have an overabundance of places like that. It's, I don't know how it is over in the UK, but it's, you see situations that happen, people to take and fall to stuff because they feel like they have no other option. While there might be options out there, they felt like they had no options because they feel like they've exhausted their options. And it leads to just generational issues.
And to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Little kids surrounded by knives and heroin needles. Represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Community outcast, cold, tired and feeble. I represent to the old folk that live alone. No family or kids at home, and all he wants is someone to speak to, but nobody thinks to phone. Sits at home in the dark, no electric. Since his wife passed, he can't accept it. He feels isolated, neglected, and now his council flat's infested. So he goes to the shop for his papers with his stick and he falls in the mud. The people around him all pulled him up, but to him that's just a reminder. He's old and he's weak with no one to love. I see
situations and stories he's telling in this is just
up above, kind of a bad day in a diary. An old man, one of many killed by society, strangled quietly. I represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Little kids surrounded by knives and heroin needles. I represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Community outcasts, cold, tired and feeble. I represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Little kids surrounded by knives and heroin needles. I represent to the people, let down by a nation and left in the streets where it's evil. Community outcasts, cold, tired and feeble.
That was freaking phenomenal. That's awesome. That was killer. I absolutely just his whole presentation, from the visuals and then the whole talking about lower end of what's considered a lower end of society and people's situations, and it's real life stuff that actually happens. Like the way this was whole, this is amazing. It's, hands down, this was freaking awesome. Man, I've missed reacting to music. Sometimes you forget how much you enjoy something until you go back, until you do it a time or two. tomorrow will be reaction to Rising Damp. And then Monday I will take and have another reaction to probably Dad's Army. Or actually, no, it's time for Blackadder. And then y'all probably get some vlogs, and I've got some skits I'm trying to work on. So, but this, I've enjoyed doing this. So, y'all be good to each other. Love yourselves. Peace.